That's what I always do. I cut it up. Blah, blah, blah. Blah, 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 blah. All right. So, I got Jana Banana here. Really pretty model, and I'm gonna try to do my best. And I'm kind of rusty. I haven't been drawing like I usually do, but because I've been bad. All right, let's go back. Cut. Cut. Spin this around. Okay. So, I am going to start with the top of the head. She has really, really long hair, so I kind of want to get that as much as possible in here. So I'm going to push the top of the head to, I'll say about right there. And I'm just going to follow the basic overall head shape, the outline of the hair. I'm just ghosting it in very light so that I can adjust it later. Let's see. There's a lot of hair to play with, different shapes. It's going to be a lot of fun. Just map this in. So that's the basic outline, and it'll change throughout the pose as we take breaks and she comes back and the hair will be different shape. So I'm not too worried about that. I just wanted to get it placed on the paper. And then I'm gonna do the hairline and guesstimate where the bottom of the chin will be. Do the outline of the face. And take that out. Bottom of the chin. So I'm going to take a measurement of the width of the face to the length by holding my pencil up and using that pencil and thumb to make that measurement across the eyes, and then judge that to the bottom of the chin, and it follows or falls right at the top of the nose, so about this distance. So the hair comes down approximately right here. Let's go ahead and work the chin. So let's do the three equal parts of the face. So that's the hairline to the brow, which is, she has arching eyebrows, so I'm just gonna guesstimate where that brow ridge would be. Then bottom of the nose, somewhere here, and bottom of the chin. So I'm gonna measure those using the pencil and my thumb, bottom of the chin to the bottom of the nose, and compare that to the bottom of the nose to the brow. And then compare that to the brow to the hairline. Approximately there. I haven't done a YouTube video in a long ass time, so I'm really nervous. And plus, having a life model, I'm really, really nervous. And I'm forgetting to breathe. Okay. Deep breath. So, got the basic shape of the face. Now we're gonna measure where the shirt lies, the V-neck, the point from the bottom of the V-neck to the bottom of the chin. Compare that to the head, so it's about equal. So we kind of come down to somewhere right here. And that point falls about right there. So I take a plumb line to find that point of the V-neck. Her neck shows a little bit right here as the hair comes around. Let's get the angle of that shirt. Got the overall placement of the big shapes, and now let's work on the features a little bit. So the center line comes down her face like so. Let's map in very softly that brow shape. You could probably hear my neighbor upstairs playing a movie. Sounds like a war movie of some sort, or maybe a zombie apocalypse movie. Of course, everybody is shelter in place right now in San Diego. So I'm just gonna map in big block shape of the features. I'm trying to guess where the nodes of the mouth will be. Looking at the outside of the nostrils compared to where that corner of the mouth might be. And I'm looking at the space under her nose to the top of the lip. Lips are open just a little bit. Bottom of the lip there. Man, I'm so nervous. Holy shit. I can't breathe. I think I'm talking too low too. I'm out of practice, that's for sure. Make the bottom lip a little bit bigger. I'm trying to decide though which lip I want to be bigger, wider. I think the bottom should be a little bit bigger than the top. I'm just gonna draw that circle for the chin. The cheekbone. this nose a little bit. Let's see. So I think I have too much chin. Let's readjust that. This side is lost in the shadow, so I might just let that be. Let's get some of the anatomy of the neck in. I don't need to get too detailed. A lot of times I'll try to get too much anatomy detail in the neck and it starts to look really intense, like they're super anxious. Too much information in the musculature in the neck. Looks like they're super anxious. Let's work on the shadow. So as the shadow comes around right here, it's going over the like a bony structure, so it's gonna be a like a firmer edge of that shadow, and then as it comes up to the softer skin of the face, that shadow will widen up a little bit and become a little bit softer. And I might be getting ahead of myself a little bit, so I'm putting in half tones already. So let's go back to the overall structure and make sure we get that right. So I've been working on the outline of her face, which is so much of the person's likeness comes from that outline. So you want to take extra time and really try to capture their look. Let's place the eyes in. So try to get that straight line so we can line up both eyes on the same horizontal line. I'm trying to make sure I don't put too much distance between the two eyes. Other side. over. The model is flirting with me. Let's see. Now I'm distracted. So she has really long eyelashes, and I'm not sure how I want to draw those yet, so I'll come back to it. It's hard not to get into too much detail all at once. I can see I gotta work on this shape of the head again. Adjust the hair shape that we did earlier. Let's just erase this part. That's why it's good to go in light at the beginning, so you can make your adjustments. Okay, we're about 17 minutes in. I'm coming up on a break at about 20. I was trying to figure out that shape right here, if I wanted to make it flare out more or not. Let's see. Pretty cool shape, I like it. Alright, so I'm looking at, I know the time is almost up, so I'm like trying to position the hair where I want it before the break. I think I might have to move the eye when I come back. Definitely have to make that eye a little bit bigger. In doing so, it would probably be a little bit lower. Let's do it now. Let's see if we got time. Yeah, we're at 20 now. So, let's go ahead and take a break. And when I come back, I'll remeasure everything, make sure that the features are in place. But so far, I think it's a pretty good start. So I'm gonna take a 5 minute and we'll be back. Okay, I'm back from break and I think I chilled out a little bit, got my nerves under control. So let's go back. And coming back, I'm trying to see if the distance from here to here on this side of the face, the far side, is too wide, not wide enough compared to this other side. So I kind of want to adjust that. And coming back also, her hair is not as far down on the forehead as it was before. But I'm going to go ahead and leave that line because I like it right there. This eye is definitely bigger than this one, so I need to adjust both of these. Shorten this one up and make this one a little bit bigger. So let's go ahead and do that. And this far side eye, because this face is wrapping around on this side, it's not going to be the same shape as this eye. It's going to kind of cut off flat on this edge right here. Let's go ahead and put some tone so I can better see it, what I'm doing here. There we go, that looks a lot better. Let's build up that bottom eyelid a little bit. And the top eyelid. Let's go ahead and put some of the eyelash back. Very exaggerated. Not sure how I want to do that. I might just leave most of it out. I'm not sure yet. I think I need to flatten that far side a little bit more. Okay, so let's go back over here and work on this eye a little bit. I always get paranoid that the camera's not rolling. I have to look over my shoulder every like 5 minutes. I need to fix this. Try to make her eye looking over to the side. I'm really distracted by these eyelashes. I'm like, just gotta be careful. This is. Continue on to the rest of the features. Actually, I'm going to work on the cheekbone a little bit here. Make this a little bit rounder. I think I have her too square. It's amazing how much. It doesn't take much to go too far one way or the other when you're dealing with the edge of the face. So I think that looks good. Let's redefine this shadow on the chin. Let's work on the nose. I think I have her nose too big. Definitely. Whoops. Hold on, I just dropped my eraser. And of course it rolled all the way to the other side of the room. Now we're back. So, I'm just thinking about the point of the nose and trying to get the perspective right so that the nose doesn't look like it's going too far this way or too far the other way. At least I didn't drop my pencil this time. I definitely dropped my pencil and it shattered. I have to go grab another one. Okay. So let's put that little cast shadow. I think it comes out about right there. It comes out of the nostril about right there. I'll just leave that there. I'll fill it in later. So right now I'm just trying to get like the basic shape of everything. So I'm just looking at the model, just trying to like see the adjustments I need. I am so out of practice with making a YouTube video. I'm finding it difficult to talk and draw at the same time. Also, having a live model is like, this is the first time I had a live model for a YouTube video. I don't think Jana Banana can hear me. She has a noise canceling earphones in right now. Let's see, I think let me put this shadow plane just a little bit so I can get the perspective. I'm thinking this lip needs to be up a little bit further, which is good because then I can make the upper lip a little bit bigger. It's really a cool shape. So I definitely want to get it just right. Let's see. And then it comes up. It's like a stair step. So you come straight across, up a little bit, and then over. Back down. And the bottom lip, the ridge is very soft. It's not extremely well defined until you get into that shadow right here. I think I made the lips too big. So let's erase some of that. And let's move this part in the lips up a little bit. Adjust the overall structure here. Actually, this part right here is going to be lost. That I'm going to have... I'm going to make this kind of like... blend in a little bit on this side. I'm going to go ahead and put in some half tones in the lip. Going to help me out a little bit. A coarse shadow on that far side, or shadow side right here. Cast shadow under the lip. Okay. Let's get out of this area. Move on. Look at some of the facial anatomy a little bit, the muscle rhythms. Let's see if I can sneak some indication in without making her look too old. That's always the problem with drawing too much information in the face. It tends to age the person. So, I think I'll just take that out. Let's see. Oh man, already 17 minutes in? Jeez. Okay. So this is the shadow side. And I'm gonna wanna put some shadow mapping a little bit. Okay, let's look. Let's see what we got here. I'm trying to find that coarse shadow on the chin. It comes up the cheek. Thank you. and put some tone in on the lower part of the face and on the shadow side. All right. Let's pull some of that dirty, messy tone I just put in. Clean it up a little bit. Time we got? I got 22. Okay, we gotta stop. Take a break. When I come back, I'll just continue working on the features. Good. Done with it fast. I'm back. There you go. Perfect. I just want to bring this side of the eye down. Deep breath. The nerves are back. All right, so what do we see that needs to be fixed? A lot. Let's take our time. Put the highlight in the eyes a little bit stronger. don't want bags in her eyes, but I do want some structure. Blend that a little bit, loose some of those lines I put in. I'm gonna put a hard edge over here and right there. A little bit overlapping. Face makes a hard edge, softens up as it goes over the forehead. Put more tone in on this side. Now I can pick out some of the highlights. In the shape of this eye. even though the neck is in light right here, I'm gonna put a lot of tone to push it down, push it in the background. Let's go ahead and put in all this tone in the darks and the shadows. Sorry I'm not talking so much on this one, but it's because I'm trying to concentrate so... I'm trying to concentrate so hard. It's so rusty. I need to start drawing every day again. I kind of let that habit kind of fall off. And now I'm paying the price a little bit. That's okay. Let's see. Come in later and fix these eyelashes. Right now I'm just going to get the basic shape. She needs more tone on this side, more half tone. There we go. Let's build up some tone on the nose, if we have time on this one, before the next break. And the far side shadow. Okay, it's getting kind of dirty looking, which means my values are out of control. So I just need to clean things up a little bit and try to connect shapes more. Ready for a break. When I come back, I'm gonna try to clean up these tones. see what we can do. It's looking a little messy right now, but we'll get a handle on it. All right, I'm back. Maybe I should try talking a little bit more. Jesus Christ. I'm so stressed out. Why is this stressing me out? Maybe it's because of a live model and I haven't done this in freaking months. Anyway, excuses. So it looks like her, I think. But I got a lot of issues. The tone is kind of dirty, but let's go ahead and put in the dark darks, I think. Kind of thinking I can do two things. I can either take out tone that I put in the face, or I can reestablish some of the darks, make them darker. And that's what I think I'll start with. So, her hair is really dark over here. So I'm just gonna go around and try to build up tone a little darker. And try to get control of the values before I move on. Oops. I think I have her features where I want them, and it looks like her. So I just need to start thinking about the values and the relationship of the values together. Cast shadow under the chin is really dark right where it begins, and then it fades out as it goes away. So already starting to look better to me as far as the values. So I feel like I can relax a little bit more, because I was really worried about that. But it seems to be working. I'm squinting at the model, and she just saw me squint, and then she's laughing at me. I know we look funny. We look funny to the models when we're like drawing them. I used to draw this one model, and she said it was so funny because she would look up at the class, and everybody's squinting at her, like a bunch of crazy psychos. So I want to put a hint of that jawline over here and see how that looks. Okay, looking good. put some texture. She's got some highlights. Kind of come across here. I didn't know that was coming from. I was like, is that your phone? You're humming to a song. That's so funny. Let's see. What time is it? Okay, we're 8 minutes in. Put these highlights in the hair. But I'm finding it difficult on this edge. Breathe. So I think I'm making the tone lighter as I go down the hair. And I think that will look pretty cool. I should probably do this when the model's on break. I'm just putting in tone. I'm not really utilizing the model right now. So go back up here, clean this up, let's cut that line a little bit. Redefine this edge. So important, this edge. And this shadow right here, let's make it darker. Let's work on the eyes. Make the eyes darker. Oops. And sorry guys, I'm not like talking, giving much instruction. I'll try to do more of that on this next one. This is what happens when you stop practicing. Put some cross hatching here and there, give it more interesting look. breathe. I'm gonna pass out. Jen and Banana over here is gonna have to resuscitate me. I'm gonna pass out and be fall on the floor. Let's see. Almost ready for another break. Okay, let's go ahead and take a break. I need to breathe. Okay. I'm back. And I'm gonna try to fix all this. Let's see. I'm kind of overwhelmed with the values again. So I'm gonna squint down and try to get them under control. And then continue from there. So squinting down, it really helps you see the values and areas that are too light and areas that are too dark. see, let's go back into the face and do some work. Haven't been doing much up here. Soften the lips a little bit. Let's see. So I was just trying to go in and redefine some of the lines, some of the edges, cast shadows, form shadows. see. My camera's flashing at me. I wonder if I'm running out of memory. Hopefully the camera doesn't shut off on me. I lost some of this line on the side, so I'm gonna come back and rework it. I'm so paranoid that the camera's gonna shut off. Better. So I started to lose some of her likeness after I put in that tone. I think it's because I kind of ran over the original drawing a little bit with the tone. So I'm also trying to decide which edges I want really sharp, which ones I want really soft. I don't want all the edges to be sharp. I want some to be soft. Man, this is a really hard one. I'm so tired. This is what I get for not drawing every day. This is punishment for not doing what I know I need to do. So don't be like me. And stop drawing for several months. Let's see, let's pull some light out here. I might be trying to do too much detail over here. That might be enough. Bring this in. So I'm gonna take some of the tone out of the face. I think. Trying to make the model smile. Man, this is really hard. I'm trying to get that perfect shape of her cheek over here. Every time I think I have it, when I come back later and look at it, I realize I don't. Time for a break. Okay. Let's work on this far side eye. She has really long eyelashes on, and it's driving me crazy on how to draw it without it looking too, contrived? I don't know. Just trying to make it look balanced, I guess. It's hard coming back from a long break. Good God. Getting my ass kicked. See, after this, Jen and Banana and I are gonna watch an old ass movie from the 80s. She's never seen it. Fast Times at Ridgemont High. That's a classic. Okay, let's look at that cheek again. And this pencil's got like little hard stones, like little hard areas in the pencil, and it cuts into the paper a little bit and creates like these scratches in the paper that pick up a tone and you can't get it out. I can see a bunch in the face, which it's kind of a bummer, but there's enough of them in the area, then it looks like it's supposed to be there. So earlier I had put in the a little indication line for the jaw, but I just took it out because I don't like it. And it actually looks better without it. This is the last 20 minutes of having the model, I think. And I'll probably work on this again in the morning without the model. I'll just work on the hair shapes and stuff. Now I want to put the jaw back in. That's so funny. Yeah, okay, that's better. dropped my pencil, but luckily it didn't break. I have to drop my pencil at least once in a video. I'm getting tired. I'm losing my momentum. Try to make that highlight pop a little bit more. Make it look really glossy. You know, I feel like I made this eye too far over. Oh, yeah. Oh. Well, we gotta take that out. What time is it? Okay, we got enough time. Bummer. That's a bummer. But I drew it once, I can draw it again. I just gotta move it over. Man, what a bummer. See, if I come up from the nostril, her eyes, the inside should be right there. Maybe a little bit more. Sucks redoing the eye at this stage. But I just went ahead and erased it right away. I didn't want to think about it too much. Because it will freak me out. Problem is, sometimes when you erase something, you'll draw right on top of what you drew before. And it won't actually make any difference. I can tell I'm doing that right here. So I'm fighting that. Those eyelashes are kicking my ass. Alright, we can do this. One step at a time. build up this structure again. God. What time is it? I got 4 minutes.
Oh shit.
Can he do it in 4 minutes? I don't know if I did anything to make it better. I think I'm blind right now. My eyes are tired. My brain doesn't work. There's nothing about this that is flowing. It's very much a fight. I think that just comes from not having practice, not having been drawing on a daily basis, and now it's a struggle. Thank you. Okay, I think I'm gonna call it for today. For what it's worth. I'll do touch-ups on it tomorrow and work on the hair. So, all right. Yeah, I think I'm done. I think I'm done for now. And then maybe in the morning I can fix it up a little bit better. All right. Cool. Done. This is terrible. It's so hard. Oh my god. Okay. Let it go. And put it away and come back and look at it tomorrow. Alright, I'm back. Next day, yesterday was freaking hard, man. It was really rough. I haven't been drawing daily like I had been, and I haven't made a video in a long, long time. So, oh yeah, and also the model being a live model versus like a photograph. It was just, all those things together made it really a real big challenge for me. And it was hard. I couldn't even like, usually I can talk and draw at the same time, but I was just out of practice. And so I didn't talk much so far about the process. Yeah, sorry about that. Definitely will do that next time as I get more warmed up and get my daily practice in like I should. So overall, I mean, even though it was a big fight, it looks pretty good. I'm just going to tweak some things and I'm going to work on the hair a bit too. Certain areas, I'm not really sure. I think this side of the face right here needs a plane change. Needs more tone, especially right here, so you can see like the structure of the face better. And I see like the lips here. I over exaggerated the corners of the mouth. I can just fix that as I need. Yeah, yesterday that was humbling. And it just goes to show you what happens when you don't practice for a while. You start to slip, you know. It's good to be back, but still, man, that was definitely humbling. So let's put this plane change on the side of the face. For some reason the pencil I have has so many hard spots in it, and it's scratching the paper really, really well. If you want, I mean, sometimes you like that texture and sometimes it's annoying. And tell you the truth, it's kind of getting annoying. It's a little too much for my taste, but it is what it is. I should probably just switch this out, but whatever, I'm already in it too deep. Better. I mean, I had such a hard time with the eye and the, eyelashes, the eye shape, the placement, everything. And it's funny, like when you're like, you gotta erase something, you made like a huge mistake, and you didn't notice it until late in the game, and you got all this value down and tone, and you're like 2 hours into the drawing, and then you realize, oh crap, I made a mistake, I didn't see it. And so I used to resist starting over on an eye or a nose, and now I just learned just to go for it and just take it on the chin and move on as fast as possible. But it's still hard to do. So I'm just going around the drawing, trying to clean some stuff up, clean up the values. There's like little pockets of tone that are kind of lost, they're not connected to anything, so I'm trying to like connect those, not shadow shapes, but like the half tone, the values, the middle tone values on the face. So I want things to feel all connected together. Otherwise it starts to look like it's like dirty, like instead of like looking like a shadow or a half tone, it'll start to look dirty if you don't connect those different shapes together. So like here on this, I guess it's kind of like a coarse shadow on the chin. As it goes over the chin, because it's a bony surface, the line is going to be a little bit firmer. And then as you go up into the fleshy, soft cheek, it's going to soften a great deal and almost get lost. You won't see that line as much. And then as you come up here on the cheekbone, again, it's a bony structure. So that line will pick up again. And it'll be a little bit harder, firmer edge, soft, and then firm again down here. So that's the kind of things I'm looking for. And also here on the edges, you see here it's a very soft, almost blurry, and then it picks up sharp right here on this edge. And then blurry again as we reach the soft cheek turn, as the face turns around. And then we come down here on the jaw, we pick up a harder line again. So it's hard, soft, and that variation creates a really nice look in this drawing, or this type of drawing. So far, so good. The eyes, I don't know, there's such a fight, and kind of got my ass kicked on that. I'm still not crazy about them, but after yesterday, I think I'll go ahead and call it, you know what I mean? Like, just say that's the best I can do for now. And as I continue my daily practice again, stay disciplined, the skill we'll come back. It just takes patience and time and dedication. I'm gonna start working in on the hair and the shapes, and so I'm kind of like, I don't want to go too much detail. There's certain areas that I certainly can, and of course I just dropped my pencil again. So there's certain areas I certainly want to go in and do some detail, but I don't want to do too much. Otherwise it'll start to look, I don't know, contrived or overdone. I'm gonna try to. I started to do those details before. Early yesterday, when I was working on this, and I was getting ahead of myself. So I'm just gonna go into the hair right now and just fix the values, kind of bring everything to in the same value ballpark. Because right now it's kind of everywhere. It's not making any sense to me right now. So I just want to get a handle on these values. So I'm squinting down while I'm looking at the hair, and I'm looking for spots that are too light in value. And then I'm coming in and bringing those values back up to the rest of the hair. Just basically trying to get it like an even tone. And then my plan is to come in with the eraser and pull out highlights in the hair, and then draw in supporting details of like the curls and the waves of the hair, the shape. Clean this area up, it looks a little dirty. There we go. And let me kind of draw in a little bit the curl shapes if I can. here. I'm trying to find the value I like for the highlight in the hair. I don't want it too bright. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and take a break. Okay, so I'm back, and I didn't like how I was doing the hair here. It was too much of the same pattern. And I think I was overdoing it, so I'm just gonna go and fill those in and go for a more simple, look. Or maybe even change up the shapes a little bit to make it more, just put more variation. I don't have the model in front of me, so I'm kind of just making this up as I go. Here in the head, where the light is strongest. Okay, that looks better. I was doing just too much of the same thing. I need to keep like variation in shapes to make it more interesting. Let's see. So I'm coming up on the end of this. I'm just sort of looking around for things to tweak, to change up a little bit. Look at the, maybe make some of these lines a little bit more crisp in the eye. Cast shadow under the nose. Under the lips. Under the chin. I'll take some of the tone out of the neck just a little bit. Kind of soften up the edges in that area because I don't want it to take too much attention. I'm trying to find a balance. First, I want most of the attention to go to the face. So this was definitely a fight on this drawing, being the first one I've done in a while, and on YouTube, and a live model, so kind of bit off more than I can chew maybe, but a nice drawing came out at least, but hopefully next time, after I do some daily practice, like I normally do, things will work out better. And they will. It'll just take a little time for the skill level to come back. Just have to be patient and dedicated. And that's about it. Okay, so my camera just ran out of memory and cut off. But basically what I was saying is I'll come back next time after some daily practice, and hopefully this will all be better. And I was just going, I don't know if it was on the if it made it on the last bit, but I was going in and reestablishing some of the hard edges on the cast shadows, like under the nose, under the lips, inside the eyes. Maybe up here in the brow. Let's try to build up this lower eyelid structure a little bit more. And there's a little bit of a cast shadow from the upper eyelashes. Just making that edge a little bit harder right there. And right here. And I think that's pretty much it. Alright, thanks for watching. See you guys next time. Bye. I'll be rolling. Alright. Final touches before I take a photo of it. How about that? On this Jana Banana drawing. Say hi, Jan and Banana.
Hi.
I'm just gonna soften up some edges. Maybe work on the highlights in the hair a little bit. And then call it. So I'm squinting down a lot to try to find out what areas need to be pushed back with tone, or what areas are too bright. And squinting down helps a lot to see those areas. I'm using my Mono Zero Tombow eraser pen, which is a really, 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 really nice tool to have. highlight is a little too light. So let's put some more tone in. Maybe even darker around it to help it pop out a little bit, but not take up too much attention. It actually. Let me try to pull that highlight out of the eye as much as I can, but I think it's about as light as I can get it. Some came out, that's good. Let's tighten it up a little bit. Okay, I'll just go ahead and call it. Thanks again for watching. Bye.